In this video, we'll be briefly covering nozzle control, containment, and masking. Containment. First, you'll need a way to capture the blasting byproducts. Some heavy plastic or a tarp will do fine. Lay out your plastic and weigh the corners down, placing your project in the center. While dustless blasting, most of the spent abrasive will fall straight down and be grounded beneath whatever you're blasting. However, pieces of abrasive with momentum can fly some distance unless you break that momentum. In this case, we can just sweep up whatever media doesn't land on our plastic. But if you're in a more delicate place or situation, you'll want to set up some simple curtains or barriers. Here's a great example by Blast Brothers. They have this simple barrier, and as a bonus, it's even branded with their business name and phone number. If you don't want to set up a barrier to stop the media's momentum, simply lay out a larger area of plastic. Masking. You'll want to mask off any delicate parts, such as glass, chrome, rubber seals, wiring, electrical, or moving mechanical parts, and anything that looks delicate or like it shouldn't have water and grit inside of it. Gorilla tape works best for this. Duct tape can also work, but sometimes it leaves adhesive behind once you remove it. Since Mike is such an experienced blaster, he didn't bother masking the wiring. By backing off and keeping the blast hose moving, he's able to remove the grease and grime from this wire without damaging the insulation. Let's take a slower look at that. You can see Mike backs off a couple of feet with the blast nozzle and brushes over the wire briefly. This is something you'll be able to do too with practice, but until you're very comfortable with your machine, it may be a good idea to mask these sorts of things just to be safe. Wheels can also be blasted without masking in most cases. Just don't dwell on the rubber or get too close. Of course, this only applies when dustless blasting. If you're dry blasting, it's nearly impossible to avoid damaging things. Nozzle control. We didn't want to blast the radiator area, but rather than sealing it off, Mike simply blasts at an angle facing away from it. Dustless blasting is very directional, as you can see by the shadow here. With clever positioning, you can avoid certain areas without having to seal them off. You can also see here that Mike is able to blast quite precisely while avoiding the soft metal grate. And by moving the nozzle farther away from it, he's able to strip it without damage. Pro tip, there's no need to adjust the blast pressure for every little delicate object. Backing the nozzle farther away has the same effect. Cleanup. At the end, it's time to clean up the waste. Depending on how much media you used, your plastic may be too heavy to move all at once. Cut it into sections and roll it up to make it manageable. And pro tip, if you have a few hours to let the water evaporate, the cleanup will be much lighter and easier. That's it for this video, but if you want to learn more tips, tricks, and techniques, be sure to check out the training section of our website.